There was this older woman in the wards who had stayed in the wards for over a month. And every time, of course, you'd go through all the files. You can't select which file because you don't know which patient was admitted on which day. And I missed the file and I was looking for that file. I was told, oh, that patient had been in the wards for some time. The next day is when I realized that the patient had been actually diagnosed with HIV as a new patient. This was a 78-year-old who had been treated for oral thrush, had been treated for the diarrheal conditions, and no one ever suspected that she could be HIV positive. And I went back thinking, I would not even have tested that patient. It's at that point that I began thinking, how many of older people out there don't actually get tested or don't even feel themselves that they could be HIV infected? How many healthcare providers reach out to older people whenever they come to the clinic to understand, you know, their sexual activity? We all assume that, you know, older people are not sexually active many times, okay. But it's at that point that I began thinking about older people. I would like to see older people receive what we call differentiated care, or care that suits them. And one of the ways that I would love to see is a care that is integrated for them. When they come into the HIV clinic, they are not seen as HIV patients, but they are seen as an older person who either has another condition or is likely to develop, you know, a chronic condition. So that when they come into the Ampath clinic, they come into a one-stop shop where they receive both HIV care, hypertension, diabetes, both for screening and if they have the condition, then for management for all. So that's what I would really love, especially for the older people. In my next phase of my research, which is my Fogarty Fellowship, I'm looking at you know, possibilities and really assessing whether it's feasible and whether it's acceptable, both to the healthcare providers and the patients themselves, and even the leadership and the funders, to integrate care for, you know, HIV and other chronic diseases. And my focus here is hypertension and diabetes, because I think those are the key ones that do happen or has a higher prevalence among the HIV population. What am I proud of? I think there's a lot that I'm proud of myself. One, achieving a PhD in an environment that I had a full-time job. I managed it, and I did it within the 3.5 years that I wanted to do it. Two, winning a Fogarty Fellowship. Let me just be very honest. That was one thing that I was extremely happy about. I was really thrilled. It's an opportunity opener for me. As a Fogarty Fellow, I am hoping to complete it in mid of 2022. My hope is the data that I collect, the pilot data, would enable me to develop a strong proposal that I would be able to apply for a career development award. National Institute of Health, and specifically the Fogarty International Center, have career development awards for international researchers, the K43s. That's my target for now. Honestly, environment changes how you are, how you behave, and what you become in your life. I must say that Ampath has shaped me to who I am today. Working at Ampath, and especially within the research realm of Ampath, I feel where I am was because of the activities that I got involved in, of, you know, the people I worked with, and, you know, the role models that I saw within the program. It is, I can say whatever I am today has been as a result of the Ampath. And the many people, I can say from the Kenyan environment, the North Americans who've come and worked with me within the Ampath research program, the whole infrastructure that has been set up within the Ampath program for research specifically shapes a lot of investigators' career, and me not excluded. I feel the involvement of, you know, the consortium institution in building, you know, the RSPO, for example, as an infrastructure that supports investigators in the management of their research funds has been a great thing. It is what sells Ampath today. We have several other infrastructures, including the research program office, including the ethics and review committee, including, you know, the lab and all that. I can't mention. And I can't say this was done single-handedly by the Moi University or Moi Teaching and Referral Hospital. Ampath Consortium played a key role in this. The National Institute of Health, NIH, who is our main funder, funds about 75% of our research in the program. Many times requires that you have a North American, you know, investigator. And as an international institution, then work with that partnering, one for building capacity and of course for improving health, because that is their key mission, improving the health and well-being of people. So having the consortium in place has created, you know, has increased our portfolio for funding opportunities, I think has increased the capacity and the infrastructure that we have in place here.